I was always big into science and science fiction, and my head was always in the stars. And so it just kind of switched at some point between, you know, thinking about outer space to thinking about the reaches of our ocean that are unexplored. For me, it's easy to be excited about being able to ask big questions and say, what is that? I want to inspire other people that science can be about just enjoying learning. My name is Melissa Anderson. I'm a marine geologist, and I'm interested in understanding how big picture plate tectonics form volcanoes and the relationship with hydrothermal venting. These are the fundamental processes that are shaping our planet, providing the chemical and energy fluxes to the ocean and to the biosphere that lives at these systems. So it's kind of the fundamental context for our understanding of our oceans and life and our planet. It's really interesting to start to go to sea and work with a lot of different collaborators and really appreciate the interconnectedness of all of the Earth's spheres. I was a baby PhD student and I was looking to get experience at sea, and I came across the first posting for Schmidt Ocean Institute's Student Opportunities Program, and I applied for it, and then I was the first student that they sponsored to come to sea. Some people are excited about meeting famous rock stars or something like that. Scientists, we get excited about meeting like authors of papers that we read. So I saw who was going to sea. It was Bill Chadwick and Ed Baker and Sharon Walker and Dave Butterfield and Joe Riesing and all the names that I knew, and I thought, I really want to get on a boat with these people. It turned out to be a fantastic learning experience. And now, 8 years later, I'm invited to go back to sea with the same group, and now I've brought my own PhD student with me. I wouldn't be here now if it wasn't for that. There are some huge challenges that we are facing, and science is the one method that we can use to figure out how to do better, how to face the challenges, how to prevent bad things from happening in the future. Ultimately, to answer the big questions that society faces, this is the way to go about it, I guess. I feel incredibly privileged to be able to do science every day. It's not so much choosing something to dedicate my life to as it is following my heart. I couldn't imagine doing anything else.